Still debating what point to make. I've got pretty wide sides on it, so I can get it thinner, make a clay out of it. And I'm thinking, since that side's really nice, I'm just gonna take my pressure flaker, raise this edge up, and shoot me some flakes across and try to get it flat. Couple off his base again. And sometimes you can actually hit it too hard and blow it off. So sometimes you just want to slow your swing speed down a little bit. See what works best. Or what works, period. Let me where my notches are. Should have told y'all that before I hit it. I'm gonna thin these areas out. Ooh, that baby's thin. Man. All right, we're gonna pressure flake and shape it up a little bit. Let's see what we come up with. This is the tool I'm gonna use. I'm not going to use the ishy stick on it. What I'm doing is I'm looking underneath the rock as I'm working it. I'm looking underneath it at anything that's hanging down. Whereas if I'm doing that, I'm looking at these areas right in here where it's low and I get heavy on the backside. I try to get some of those out. I'm just looking for anything that hangs down that's not. Let's see if it looks better. See how the little teeth are? See how up and down, up and down, up and down? I would be taking those off is what I'm looking at. On this base end. Rock flake's good. Brake's good too. Experienced that last night. Hour and 45 minutes. Snap. It's like great. And we're talking about an 8-inch point. Shh. 8 inches. We're going to come in here with two notches, and we're going to clip it, and you're going to say, God, dog, that's a fine looking point. All right, let's notch it. All right, I'm just going to get an idea. That's going to be my center. So I'm going to come in about right here, and that's my center. I'll come over here to right there. Yeah, that looks good. There and there. All right. You see what we did? How thin that thing is. Alright. Now I'm going to braid that just a little bit inside their grooves. And I'm going to try to get lucky and get two nice. Oh yeah. Shot it up to here. Flakes up in there. That went to there. To keep it real thin, because if we can keep it thin, we can go a long ways. All right. Now these here. They're going to go in an angle and up in a big circle and come back out like this. We're just going to make loops in here. You'll see. I always make it a little bigger than I need to, because you do break off little tips and all that stuff as you go. So as you get inside the piece, you make it big, and then once you get done and you start refining, then you can go back and you can take away and sharpen them corners up.